Well, I think it's about time. The way the corn's been growing for the last two or three generations.
Look at that herd of buffalo. They're ready.
Everything's living the Great Spirit's way, in harmony.
He'll be here soon.
The true white brother's coming home. Remember what the Great Spirit said? If we did what we were supposed to do and lived according to the plan, white brother would finish his work in the East and come back to us.
It'll be nice to have the family together again.
Buenos dias, amigo.
Hello, you must be the true white brother.
Sure, you must be the Indians.
Yes.
Welcome home.
Welcome to New Spain. This is your new father, Father Corona.
Down on your knees now. Do you recognize what I'm holding over your heads, lads?
It's a cross, the symbol of the quartering of the universe into active and passive principles.
God have mercy on their heathen souls.
What the father means is, what is the cross made of? Gold. Have you got any?
No.
What about the seven cities of gold? Phoenix, Tucson, Las Vegas?
This is gold.
What's that?
Corn.
Hey, corn! Now we can make tortillas!
We've been waiting for this for hundreds of years.
I just invented tacos!
So this is all you got?
Yes, but aren't you the true white brother who's supposed to come and live with us in peace?
Sure. Therefore, I claim this rich word in the pasture land in the name of the Empire of Spain.
Hey, Capitano, the rain, she's a stopper to fall, and the corn, she's all dead.
Shut up, Vespucci. I claim this stinking desert in the name of the Empire of Spain forever. Let's go.
God bless Vespucci land.
Oh, by the way, Domini, you're all Catholics now. God bless you.
Come on, and Father, nobody in their right mind would live in this stinking desert.
Come on, Cisco.
Boy, I'm tired of pushing west. How long ago we leave Goshen?
About 2 hours ago. Ain't we ever gonna stop?
Quiet down now, boys. Wagon boss.
My fellow settlers.
Hold it down.
We stand here at the edge of civilization on the banks of the Mississippi River, looking west at our destiny. What may appear to the faint-hearted as a limitless expanse of God-forsaken wilderness
is
in reality a golden opportunity for humble, God-fearing people like ourselves and our families and our children and the generations a-coming to carve a new life out of the American Indian.
Welcome, white brother.
Engines! Pull the wagons up into a circle!
Why do you always do that?
We get better reception that way. Do you mind if I put this antenna up on yonder peak?
That's our sacred mountain.
This is our sacred antenna. It's shaped like a cross, made out of aluminum. Got any aluminum?
We've still got some corn left.
Hey, corn! Now we can make whiskey!
We've been waiting hundreds of years for this.
We just invented a Tom Collins.
Here, engine, you want some fire water?
No. We were warned by our elders not to drink anything that would make us weak or silly.
Put it in their well.
That's not a well. It's the eye of the Holy Serpent Mound on which you're standing.
It's a butte.
No, it's a mound.
And right purdy, too. Can you move it?
But why?
Railroad's coming through. Right now.
Hey, what are we stopping for?
We in Goshen yet?
Can't go no further. This here's engine territory.
Well, then, it's treaty time!
My fellow Redskins, speaking for the great white father in Washington and all the American people, let me say we respect you, savages, for your native ability to instantly adapt and survive in whatever godforsaken wilderness we move you to. Out there. Sign here.
They did it!
No reason to complain. It's not so bad out there. We still have our people and our ceremonies and the sun, moon, and stars and the sand and the black stuff coming out of the ground.
Black stuff coming out of the ground?
Civilization! Oh!
Civilization!
Oh, it's nice out here in the desert. No rain, no crops, no white brother.
All out for Fort Stinkin' Desert. Last Indian reservation for 2,000 miles. You got 15 minutes, folks. Get them while you can.
Get the senator back in the bus.
Godfrey Daniel, pesky redskins. Which way's Goshen?
Howdy there, colorful replica of America's past. When is the exciting in its primitive splendor snake dance going to take place?
It's usually in August, but with all our children off in Indian school, there's no one left to do the ceremonies.
Hiya, Pop.
I'm home.
Hello, Soaring Eagle. It's good to have you back from school.
Oh, come on. Call me Eddie. I'm an American now.
What have they been teaching you?
Just what we need for a better life. French horn, Italian, water polo.
Yes, at the Custer Memorial Indian School, Eddie's one of our prize students. We're giving him away next week.
Oh, my white brother.
Hey, man. Don't let him bring you down now. There's a lot of young people in this country just like myself who really know where the Indian's at. And don't worry, soon we're all going to be out here on the reservation, living like Indians and dressing like Indians and doing all the simple, beautiful things that you Indians do. You got any peyote?
Hey, how much is that necklace you're wearing?
Do you know how to do the war dance?
Hold it, smile.
It's amazing how they survive on this stinking
you
desert.
You got any scalps?
Hey, let me get a shot of you and your squaw.
Hey, let's see the war dance.
Let's see the dance.
Let's see the dance.
Dance. Dance.
Dance.
Dance.
Dance. Dance. Dance. Dance. Dance. Dance.
Okay, okay, folks. Fun's over. Back in the bus.
Where's little Billy Joe?
He's in that run-down outhouse over there, Mama.
That's our sun altar.
Well, Indian, just goes to show you there's an obvious need to conserve our priceless national heritage. The government is turning your home into a national monument.
It behooves me upon this historic occasion to dedicate the Stinking Desert National Historical Indian Monument and Cobalt Testing Range.
Civilization! Hoo!
It's about time. There's been no corn growing for the last few generations. The buffalo's gone. There's no one left to live in harmony.
I wonder where we went wrong.
Let's just keep to the life plan. Remember what the Great Spirit said. Follow the peaceful way. The true white brother is bound to come.
All right, Indians, get ready.
Winning of the West, the massacre, take four.
Well, let's go.
And collective love farm. Take off your clothes and come on in.
Om. Om. Range.
Here, let me lay a stick of sandalwood incense on you. Made it out of my old sandals. No, no, no. Let me light it for you. Let me show you around the place a little bit. Oh, wow. Hey, man, where all those little people with the melty hats and the walls go? Hey, hey, man, now that you're so old, down home travel and all that, I'm going to take you up to the second bardo and orient you. Here's our Good Games People playroom.
Hello, my
My name is Mello Jello. I am the head of the athletic department. I head the athletic department. I am the athletic department head. Here. Oh, okay, beginners. Everybody into the full lotus position. Oh, yes. Oh, that's very good. Yes, that's very good. Now you are going to stay there until you obtain true enlightenment.
Oh, many blessings. Grub, grub.
Grubs again. Grumble, grumble.
Folks, let me turn you on to medium rari, our mystic chef and guru.
Welcome to my humble chug wagon. While you are here, we will have everything from soup to nuts. Tonight, we have mushroom soup and beetle nuts. Here, have some grubs. Oh, they are very tender baby worms, cooked over incense in holy corn oil. That's oil from the corns of holy men, known in your country as polyunsaturated ghee.
Scalp 'em, tantric.
Groovy, Kimasabi.
Hi ho, electric blue! Away!
Ranger's on a bum trip again. Howdy, Brahmachari. I'm Gabby, your sacred cowboy. You know, this reminds me very little of the time my guru sent me out to clean up the karma in Artful Dodge City. I stumped into the Last Chance Saloon.
Arahansa Yogan and a party boo.
Hey, give me some more of that third red eye, Bucky.
You've had it. That's your last chant, cowboy. Out!
There's a passel of them theosophists at the other end of the bar raising the devil. Had him about 10 feet off the floor. I could tell by the red clay on his hooves and his black aura that he was up to no good. So I look him straight in the eye and I said, Sam Paku, there ain't enough room in this life cycle for both of us. That little devil up and challenged me to a game of 10-card tarot, Pentacles Wild. I seed him deal a high priestess from the bottom of the deck and then... It's Lieutenant Behind of the 7th Seal Cavalry.
I need 3 men! 1 from Kome, and 2 from Kombi! Drop! Ho!
Howdy, Lieutenant Behind. What's up?
We ain't. Got some more loco weed?
Sure. Got some road apple red right here.
Which way'd we go?
You went that away.
There will be an out-of-sight mandatory sunrise light show at the main desert at 5:48 sidereal time, lovers. That is all.
Procession will be starting soon. Let's go pick up tiny Dr. Tim and head into the sunrise. Now this here simple life-size replica of the Taj Mahal, made entirely out of oleomargarine, houses our guru, Dr. Tim. Let's knock on the door and see if he's in. Howdy, Dr. Tim.
I just thought I'd drop out and say hello. Hello.
Come back, Dr. Tim. We want to talk to you.
Oh, welcome to the link of Spirited Guhuri, LSG. Wait a minute. Oh, well, another day, another green, blue, electric, yellow dollar. Got anything to drink? Anything at all?
And why is it that you're drinking, Timmy, me boy?
Because it's bad for my hullabaloosins. I get a chance to see things in real black and white. I despise electric pink.
You know, Dr. Tim is keeper of the sacred tablets.
Yeah, have a tablet. Oh, nice, paisley, horsey. Give the nice horsies some sugar cubes.
Well, Dr. Tim, everyone's gathered for the Daily Miracle. Here's your microphone.
Everyone!
since the Sonners took LSD, it's been a fundamentally better sun. More pink and green and electric blue. Let's hope it comes up again today.
Here it comes.
He's done it again. It's coming up. It's coming up.
Oh, it's Paisley.
Is anybody going to sing for an ass?
All right, group. It's time to meditate on the pure white light of stupidity. Let's hear it for our guru. One, two, three.
G-U-R-U.
I'm not at all happy with the flashcard section. Now come on, you freaks. Say the word and you'll be free. Say the word and be like me. Say the word I'm thinking of. Have you heard? The word is
love. 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 Love.
Hey, Larry, dig that chick.
Oh, she's groovy.
Hey, man, are you ready for that spade?
Wow. He's groovy. All spades are groovy.
Dig that chick. She's groovy.
Yeah, she's groovy.
Right.
Hey, dig that.
She's not groovy.
Mm-hmm.
Peace, baby.
You talking to me, man?
Sure, baby. Come on over here. I want to do a thing with you.
You, want a roofer?
No, man.
Reaper?
Forget it.
Ringer?
Where's your miniskirt?
I forgot it! Oh, I knew I should have come.
Cool it, lady. Don't get uptight.
Come over here in the light so we can check your body paint. Faded San Francisco Art Nouveau.
Sure, she must be an oldie.
Are you holding?
Natch! Jackson, of course I'm holding. I got it right. Oh, you took my stash from me. This is a frame-up.
Dig, Larry. Aspirin.
Let's do her a favor. Phone her in.
I tell ya, I took all the uppers. You want to hear me rap? I saw the best minds of my generation.
Put her in the car.
Put her in the back
seat.
Out of sight. Call her into Dr. Benway.
Oldie but Goldie City, Benway here.
Hey, Doc. Got one for re-grooving. Be right in.
Groovy.
How's the Blue Cadillac Psycho Raga Rock Old Folks Dance Marathon doing?
They're dropping like flies.
Groovy. Oldies but Goldies.
Superintendent of Schools here.
Groovy.
Groovy. Hey, man, it's about your kid, Malcolm X John Lennon. He dropped in today.
You mean?
Benway, your kid's a drop-in.
It'll kill his mother.
I just talked to your father. He's groovy.
Yeah, I like Pop.
Well then, baby, how come we found you in a classroom today? Why weren't you hanging out in the parking lot relating with the rest of the kids and teachers?
I don't smoke. Can I go now?
Yeah, do your thing. Hold it. Leave those books here.
Malcolm X John Lennon? Come on in and dig your mother.
Ah, Mom, I can't now. I gotta go do my homework. I mean, I gotta meet my connection.
You can't fool me. You're in one of those underground study cells, aren't you?
No!
It'll kill your father. I didn't breastfeed you for 14 years for this. Come here, baby.
But, Mom, I'm not hungry.
Straightneck. Do yourself a favor. Be groovy. Now sit down, turn on, and tune in the TV.
But, Mom, I don't want to watch television.
Oh, you're so weird.
And now, direct from the Paisley House on Capitol Hill, man, we take you to the gathering of the tribes, which is already in session.
Now let me shock it to you, baby. It's clear from these underground films shot in your bedroom by the Free Food and Drug Administration that you've been doling out unauthorized bread and water to a chick who lost a free food card.
But Senator, baby, like she was starving.
Young man, that's her trip. take him away for re-grooving.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Paisley House on Capitol Hill, your spot for the best in food, fun, and dancing, proudly presents the fastest rise in interim governmental administration in the Western Hemisphere, the Cabinet of the United States of Beat. From Rochester, New York, on lead guitar, the Secretary of Peace. On drums, the Secretary of Inner Self. On saxophone, the Secretary of States of Consciousness. And here he is, ladies and gentlemen, the expected, the most high chief of the United States of Being, Star Van Cool.
Do you love me? Yes, we do. On this birthday, the founder of our tribe, Sodom Clinton Powell, the first to take our sacred oath. If elected, I refuse to serve. Wow! I come to present new hippification, the first treaty of world peace. Some of you cats may recall the old days of the brown shoe, when there was war and fight and soldiers.
Yes, those were ungroovy times.
Well, now there's no more war anymore, and no soldiers. Except for our brave boys, living their trip in Nigeria.
Mr. Chieftain, representing the Young People's Soviet Social Republic, it's a guest to sign this jazzy document. We too want peace of Nigeria.
Yesterday, a full million of us in the Hippie Republic of China met in my room to debate this question. We threw I Ching out the window. We are now unanimous.
How sweet it is. Hey, Secretary of Peace, baby, what are we putting down in Nigeria?
Major Hit is on the screen now with the daily upfront report.
Ciao, baby. This is Major Hit in the cockpit of the Enola McLuhan, flagship of the 7th Airborne Peace Corps and Lending Library. We're now over the center of rebel resistance in northern Nigeria and preparing to drop literature.
Do the Bombay door thing. Bombay door swinging and open, baby. Ruby and out. Bombardier, it's your karma.
We're almost ready to drop it. I can see the entire rebel force running out of their huts, looking up at the sky.
7, 14, 11, 16, Lazy Star Dog. Lazy Star Dog. Target ready. Hucks away!
There they go. The literature is in a tight pattern. The rebels are beginning to scatter, but it's too late. On target! This is an awesome moment. The last stronghold of unhip resistance is out of sight. Under 8 million hardbound copies of The Naked Lunch. It's all over. We're coming home.
This is Side 5. Follow in your book and repeat after me as we learn 3 new words in Turkish. Towel. Bath. Border. May I see your passport, please?
Yes, I have it right here.
Look at this.
This photograph doesn't look a bit like you now, does it, sir?
Well, it's an old picture.
Precisely.
Is there anything wrong?
Oh, no. Would you mind waiting over there, sir? Oh, just leave your bags.
But my passport...
Next, please.
Information. May I help you, sir?
Yes, I'd like to know...
Not what... for 12 hours. You'll be informed at your hotel.
Yes,
Would
but...
you like to send a wire?
Well, yes, I guess I'd better.
One moment, please.
right, sir. Do you want this to be a night letter, regular, or guaranteed delivery?
Which is fastest?
At this time of day, they all receive equal attention, depending, of course, on the zone involved. Which zone was that, sir?
I'm sending it overseas.
No, please, the zone. Look at the map.
Well, then I suppose it would be...
I beg your pardon, sir, but is this your bar of soap?
I suppose it is.
So do we.
All right, sir, your telegram has been sent. You will be receiving it in about an hour. Guaranteed delivery. That'll be 275, sir, no tax.
Well, I haven't had a chance to change my money yet.
Just a moment, sir. Is this your bag?
No, it's not.
Check it again. Do take your time, sir.
This is definitely not my bag.
Just as we thought. Sign here, please. And here. And here. And here. And here. And here. And here. Thank you, sir.
We've sent your bags on ahead, sir. Where is it you're staying?
What's the best hotel in town?
Of course! Taxi! The taxis, they are all on strike. And it's too early for the bus. You really are a problem, sir. I suppose we'll have to put you up.
Going up!
Скажите, товарищу, как вы подумаете о нашем городе?
Oh, excuse me, but my friend would like to know how much you enjoy our city so far.
Actually, I haven't been here too long.
Il n'y a pas été beaucoup de temps ici.
Ну, рассказывайте мне, да или нет?
Oh, he want to know yes or no.
Well, tell him yes. It's a beautiful city.
Не кричайте, слышу.
He says he can shout, don't hear you. Have you seen the palace?
Not yet, but I certainly intend...
Oh, you must. It won't be here much longer, you know. They are cleaning it.
Он на единственный?
Are you alone?
Yes.
No. We are here with you.
Oh, I see what you mean. No.
Yes. How many are we?
Here? Three.
You don't want to count the elevator boy?
Yes.
Three or four?
Four.
But, of course, there's your family.
But they're not traveling with me.
Where?
Where I'm going.
But you're here. How many?
Four. With the elevator boy.
Ah, he is in your family.
No, here.
And here we are.
Ladies and gentlemen, our distinguished guest has just arrived.
Have some champagne.
What do you mean?
Come this way. Gentlemen, port and cigars in the war room. Lord Kitchener will join us presently.
Hurry along.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't realize...
Gentlemen, please. In these troubled times, besieged as we are on all fronts,
here.
There is but one man in whom we can place with complete assurance our faith, hope, and destiny.
There.
A man who has won more battles than he has fought.
Where?
A man who has the confidence of his people. Our generated, veneered leader, our own fighting Jack, Lord Kitchener. Kitchener!
He knocked over the pitcher. He's dead.
You'd better come with us.
We're no longer safe
here. Let's to the Winter Palace, quick.
Oh, it's the ice show.
Und jetzt von der Berliner Eispalast und Festspiel der Frühlingsspieler stets der Genackfestprobe Franz und Juni.
Hallo,
Hans!
Hallo,
Benny!
Hallo!
Where are you taking me?
We don't have much time, and there's a lot you have to know.
Now, listen carefully. If the revolution is to be successful...
Excuse me.
Wait, first thing.
The revolutionary leadership...
No, I was talking about the codification. The codification is the central control. It's
The expediency...
According to the regulations...
Check. Right, everything has got to be done in this time.
You have to have the priority of rank.
Right.
Do you mind if I...
Of course.
There is absolute security and necessity.
Got it.
All of these operations.
I'll take it from here. Follow me. Right, Chief.
Gentlemen, I won't take any more credit for this victory than necessary. Lord Kitchener did not, nay, will not die in vain, grid willing. Gentlemen, I as leader will use power like a drum and leadership like a violin. Pick out any idea, compare ideas with the one idea left, you have no doubt, and without a doubt, we have enthusiasm. Gentlemen, to make life whole. It's as easy as a bridge. Now, gentlemen, now that we have attained control, we must pull together as one, like a twin, keeping the prophecy of power as enthusiasm. All for one!
All for one!
And all for one!
And all for one!
Let me hear it for me!
You're under arrest!
Hello. My, it will be pleasant to have you here. I've not had any company in this dank and dismal cell for 40 long and miserable years. I was imprisoned by a faceless people for a crime of which I had no knowledge and certainly did not commit, but what of that? In me spare time, I have been pursuing me hobby, which is writing a great prison novel. In the beginning, I wrote with an ink composed of parts of me own blood. However, this would not make an acceptable carbon, so I acquired an electric typewriter. I am proud to be able to present you with the first edition of me saga of eternal torment, profusely illustrated, titled Leather Thighs.
Guard! I want to see my ambassador.
Easily done. He's in the next cell.
Use the telephone.
I don't have a dime. Here, use one of the pages of me novel.
It's no good. They're tapping the lines. Oh, if I could only speak to someone, if I could only tell my story.
Famous writer to see the condemned man.
Oh, you poor brute of a killer without a conscience. I'm wet with compassion.
Excuse me, but it's always a pleasure to meet another member of the writing fraternity. Perhaps you would like to hear an excerpt from me great prison novel of eternal torment in cold leather. Oh, God.
Hey, what's troubling you, son?
Padre... I'm tired of living and...
Old man, river.
Now give me that gun.
I don't have a gun, Father.
Here, have one of mine.
I'm not afraid of justice. I know these bars are here for a good reason. Prisons are for the guilty.
String him up.
Anybody got me, Spring?
He's just like the kid.
No, don't you guys see? The system is here for your protection. I'm not afraid. All I want is a chance to clear my name. Look, we live and operate under the due process of law. The innocent have nothing to fear. Only the guilty will suffer.
Lynch him.
Anybody got me, Lynch?
He even looks like the kid.
Look, it's this simple. I'll get a hearing and a trial. I'm willing to place my fate and faith in the hands of justice.
What happened to the lights?
They just burned the kid.
Mother? Mama, I'll be good.
Mama, I will. Mama, I'll be good. Mama, I just want to get out of here.
Hey, Mame, you think he's going to make it?
I don't know. He looks pretty sick to me. Hey,
I think he's coming around.
He's coming around, folks. He's gonna be okay and ready to play Symptom 6 of Beat the Reaper.
Last week, our patient successfully survived the common cold, measles, pneumonia, dengue fever, and the yaws.
And now, the big question. Are you ready to go on?
What? Where?
He's ready!
Meanwhile, our topless nurse, Judy, is wheeling our patient into the isolation ward.
Can you hear me in there? Okay, let's shoot him up. Now, patient, you have 10 seconds to tell us what you've got and beat the Reaper!
I'm shaking, feverish. My hands are all... yellow, my God, I've got jaundice.
Jaundice it is! Give him that! That's symptom 6. And now you've reached the final threshold. Here's the question. Are you ready for symptom number 7? Longer than any patient has ever survived before.
I want to go home.
Only one way to do that. Doctor, bring in the super shot.
Now, for the first time on Beat the Reaper, we're going for the big disease. The icebox is being unlocked by the president of the Armenian Medical Association, under whose strict supervision these toxins are being administered.
This is it. Doctor, give him that really big disease. Now, patient, can you hear me? You've got 10 seconds to tell us what you've got, and for the last time, beat the Reaper!
I think I feel... I don't know, whatever... whatever it is, I want to die.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. That's not correct. You didn't beat the Reaper. Doctor, bring the patient out and show the amphitheater audience and all the folks at home just what he's contracted.
According to my careful prosthesis, this man has the plague.
Thank you, Doctor.
You're welcome.
You've got the plague. Well, isn't he a good sport, folks? We'll be back in just a moment with our next patient, but first...
Taxi, buddy.
Oh, thank God.
Where to, Mac?
Out.
Sure thing. I'll take you to the border. I'm gonna have to cut through the park.
Is that the fastest way?
No, it ain't, but the plague's got the streets all tied up.
Well, just do the best you can.
Sure thing.
Hey, are those my bags?
Oh, yeah. We've been watching you every step of the way, but we ain't had a chance to contact you till now.
You mean...
Sure. What do you mean?
Well, I mean...
Listen, buddy, let me give you a piece of advice. What you don't mean won't hurt you. Mind if I turn on the radio?
In a massive traffic tie-up, as the death rate continues to soar. Now, let's go to the river's edge and Charles B. Smith.
Ed, it's an amazing scene here. Like lemmings, the crowds are waiting on the shore. Torches blazing as the long line of shrouded funeral rafts drift lazily into view. Great black candles flickering at helm and stern. The excitement is contagious, and so are the Black Cross volunteers as they pass from family to family, pausing now and again to touch a child's head. I wish I could, but I can't. So long, Ed.
Thank you, Charles. And now here's another feature in our continuing report on the...
Hey, Mac, what'd you turn it
off
for?
How close are we to the border?
Well, at this rate... Uh-oh, I think they spotted you.
I want to die! Touch me!
I want to die!
Can't we go any faster?
There's too many of them.
What can we do?
I don't know. Throw him your coat.
Run to me! Run to me!
I want to die! Here's the border up ahead.
Thank God.
No, not yet. We'll never make it through that crowd at the gate unless you do exactly what I say. Take off all your clothes.
What?
Come on, buddy. Take them off.
Right.
I know. When I give the signal, toss them out, and I'll drive this heap right through the barrier. Ready?
Yes, yes, that's everything.
Okay. Here we go.
This way. That's it. You've made it. Welcome to side 6. Follow in your book and repeat after me as we learn our next 3 words in Turkish. Coffee. Delight. Border. May I see
your passport?